They say it takes 10,000 hours to master a skill, but the piano professor says it should take a lot less. It's all about how you practice, not how long. That's what we focus on. Now, let's look at today's video.
The question, how often is the soft pedal of the piano used in performance? Along with the sustain pedal, it is one of the most misunderstood aspects of a piano. While it is true that it softens the sound, by reducing the hammer blow distance on upright pianos, and by reducing the number of strings that a hammer strikes, the most important aspect is giving the pianist the ability to control the harmonics, or tonal colors, on a grand piano. By shifting the hammer slightly, you are striking just 2 out of 3 strings. The third string is not struck, but immediately begins to vibrate sympathetically. Because its vibration is not initiated by the hammer, it vibrates differently from the strings that were struck by the hammer. This alters the color of the note, and typically involves greater harmonic components. Also, the density of the hammer where it strikes the strings may be different from the normal position. It is typically softer, thus the duration of the contact with is longer, again resulting in different harmonic components. A competent pianist varies the degree to which the hammers are shifted from the to fully exploit the tonal palette available in the piano. The degree to which the pianist uses the soft pedal is a marker of an artist who really listens to the sound and exploits all the available possibilities. Learning the piano without spending decades on it is about working smart, not hard. You can access the Piano Professor Pack in the link below. It focuses on abusing diminishing returns to get the best results possible.